day and God's blessings to all the wonderful people of the Virgin Islands. The year 2021 has been a year of highs and lows.
Andrew Foy hadn't reckoned on the lows of 2022. He's brought scandal and corruption to the British Virgin Islands. According to charges filed in the US, he'd agreed ports in the British Overseas Territory could store cocaine. In exchange, he'd get a cut of the profits. Mr. Foy thought he was dealing with a Mexican drug cartel, but the plan was a sting by undercover US agents.
It's not shocking to me to see something like this, but as far as I'm concerned, it's a good thing because it sends a strong message to others that if you're involved in drug trafficking, corruption, you know, justice will sooner or later fall on your head.
Court papers describe how Mr. Foy used a calculator to work out how many millions he'd make. In the same papers, a port official, who's also been arrested, said of Mr. Foy, "You see, of my premier, he's a little crook sometimes. He's not always straight."
The Caribbean is an incredibly important transit route for the cocaine trade, and it goes across to the narco states of West Africa, Guinea-Bissau, Senegal. They're all run by international cartels.
The British Virgin Islands are a tropical tax haven, but there's a shady side to the secretive goings-on here.
That is, please, a yes or no question.
I don't think that you could ask me and tell me how to answer, you know, with due respect.
Last year, the UK started an inquiry into allegations of misgovernance. It made headlines when the former Attorney General Geoffrey Cox represented Andrew Foy. Publications being brought forward following the arrests. The inquiry found appalling failings and recommended the government be suspended for 2 years with direct rule by the governor. A difficult decision for local politicians. They've lost their powers and probably their premier.